Hello everyone, in this video we have one square, and here is given 2, here is given 4, and this length is given 6 units. And then the question is, what is the area of the blue shaded trapezium? Okay, first of all, let's call one perpendicular line like this. If you notice that this triangle and this triangle are similar, right? Therefore, if there's a 6x, opposite of the 6, so opposite of the 2 must be equal to x. Therefore, the similarity ratio between these two triangles is 6x over 8x, right? So 3 over 4, that means if there's a 3m here, this length must be equal 4m. After that, let's draw one more perpendicular line. If it is 3m, that means here must be equal 3m and m unit left here. So this length, let's call here n. If you focus on this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, m squared plus n squared equal 4. Then for this triangle, we can also apply Pythagorean theorem. So n squared plus 9m squared equal 16. So if you multiply the first equation by minus, these terms become negative. After that, if we add the equations together, these are again. So 8m squared equal 12. That means m squared equal 12 over 8. So 3 over 2, therefore m equal root 3 over root 2, so root 6 over 2. That's right here. Here is 4m, right? 4m equal 4 times root 6 over 2, so 2 root 6. That's right here, 2 root 6, and let's call here y. For this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, 2 root 6 whole squared plus y squared equal 8 squared, right? So 24 plus y squared equal 64. That means y squared equal 40. So y is going to be 2 root 10. That's right here, 2 root 10. Therefore, trapezium area equal, let's clear here, trapezium area equal, this length is 2 root 2 minus 2 root 6, right? And here, this length is 2 root 10. So now we can calculate trapezium area easily. Base 1 plus base 2. 2 root 10 over 2 times height, right? Height is 2 root 10. Therefore, trapezium area equal 2 root 10 minus root 6 in parentheses times 2 root 10. So the area equal 40 minus 2 root 15 units squared. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of the area using second method. First of all, if you draw a median like this, these two parts must be equal. So 2 units left here, and this part must be equal 4 units. And then this length is also 4 units, right? Let's remind you, if we have a right triangle, and if we draw a median, these three parts must be equal to each other. Okay. So let's call here alpha. That means here must be equal alpha, right? Because this triangle is an isosceles triangle. We know that sum of the two opposite interior angles equals one exterior angles. So here must be equal to alpha. And if you focus on this triangle is also an isosceles triangle, so here must be equal 90 minus alpha, right? Okay. So now also, if you focus on this triangle is also an isosceles triangle. So if you draw a perpendicular line like this, base must be divided into two equal parts. So these two parts must be equal 1 unit, right? Okay. And then this angle is right here. This angle is 90 minus 2 alpha, right? Okay. Therefore, if we calculate sine 90 minus 2 alpha, for this triangle, sine 90 minus 2 alpha equal 1 over 4, right? Okay. We know that sine 90 minus 2 alpha equal cosine 2 alpha equal 1 over 4, and the expansion of cosine 2 alpha equal 1 minus 2 times sine squared alpha equal 1 over 4. Therefore, 1 minus 1 over 4 equal 2 times sine squared alpha. So sine squared alpha equal 3 over 8. Let's square root both sides of the equation. Therefore, sine alpha equal root 6 over 2 root 2. So let's multiply with root 2. Numerator and denominator, therefore sine alpha equal root 6 over 4. Next step, let's call here x. If you focus on this triangle, sine alpha equal x over 8. Sine alpha is also equal root 6 over 4. Therefore, x equal, let's simplify, 2 root 6. So let's write here 2 root 6. After that, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the side 2 root 10, right? Okay. Therefore, let's create here. Trapezium area equal, this time let's calculate it using the other method. If you subtract this right triangle area from square area, we get the blue shaded area. Right? So square area equal 2 root 10 whole squared minus triangle area 2 root 10 times 2 root 6 over 2. Therefore, trapezium area equal 40 minus 2 root 15 unit square. Okay. So the second method, now we will calculate the area using third methods. First of all, let's call here alpha. That means here must be equal 180 minus alpha, right? Next step, let's call here x, and this side, let's call here y. For this triangle, if we apply cosine rule, x squared equal 2 squared plus 4 squared minus 2 times 2 times 4 times cosine 180 minus alpha. If we apply the cosine rule for this triangle this time, y squared equal 4 squared plus 6 squared minus 2 times 4 times 6 times cosine alpha. Right? And we know that cosine 180 minus alpha equal minus cosine alpha. So if we apply this property for the question, cosine alpha, but notice that minus sine will become plus, right? After that, if we add these two equations, x squared plus y squared equal 4 plus 16 cosine alpha plus 16 plus 36 minus 48 cosine alpha, right? Okay. How we can calculate x squared plus y squared? Of course, Pythagorean theorem. So x squared plus y squared must be equal 64. Therefore, 4 plus 16 plus 16 plus 36 equal 72, and 16 cosine alpha minus 48 cosine alpha equal minus 32 cosine alpha. Therefore, 32 cosine alpha equal 8, so cosine alpha equal 8 over 32, so cosine alpha is going to be 1 over 4. Therefore, if you plug in this value to the first equation, we get x as 2 root 6 and y is 2 root 10. So after the calculations are done, the area is going to be 40 minus 2 root 15 unit square. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.